Hi, welcome back to the tutorial. In today's video, we'll learn about data control in Data Studio. Filters or controls are frequently used in websites for users to be able to find the information they need based on some characteristics selected. This applies to Data Studio as well. So in Data Studio, we can use the date range control to filter the data to a specific date range. To access the control, you can click on this Add a Control button. In today's tutorial, we will focus on two of the common types of data control in Data Studio. So first, let's start with the drop-down filter. First of all, we have this dashboard that we have been creating. I know it's a little bit messy here, but just bear with me. Maybe it's more cleaner if I move everything down a little bit. And here we can start. So first of all, we're going to add a control, which is over here. There's a button. Just click on it and select drop down list, and similar to how we add a chart, just click on the canvas and you will have this filter in this report. And Data Studio will select the random field for your data control. So what you're going to do next is to define this control field. In this example, we're going to pick country, which is the delivery country. So just drag and drop it into the control field. Next, you can also resize this filter by dragging the edge, just like how you resize the charts in Data Studio. So since November last year, Data Studio has made a big improvement on Data Studio interactivity in edit mode. So now you can select the filter even in edit mode. So when I click on this delivery country filter, I can see all the options here. So let's say I want to see only US in this dashboard. I can just click on this only button over here. And all the charts will be filtered based on that. You can also select more than one country from the dropdown. Say for example, we can select Canada. So to select more than one country from the dropdown, we will have to select using the tick at the front of the values. Whereas if you just want to have one value being selected, just click on this only button. By default, you are allowed to select multiple values from the drop-down filter. So to configure the setting to allow single select only, you can go to this property panel at the style tab. Under the control section, there's one single select over here. We can just click on this. Now when we try to select US, you can see that we no longer see the only button shows up when we hover on it. And now we can only select one country. Say if I select United States, and if I want to select Canada now, so the previous value will be cancelled automatically when you select the next one. So that's how we use the single select. But for this dashboard, I want to keep it as multiple select. So I'm just going to untick the single select. Moving on, we can also customize this filter control. Earlier when we click on these filters, it shows the delivery countries along with the numeric numbers at the right to represent the total transaction IDs. So this can come handy if you want to sort the control values with the metric. Say for example, if you don't want to use transaction ID to sort the countries, you can use total customers to sort the delivery country. So for now, let's try to change this transaction ID to total customers. So click on the filter and then at the data tab, we're going to look for total customers, which is the buyer. Drag it to the metric. And we can now see that now the metrics has changed to buyer. We can also change the label over here. It's very similar to how we do it for the charts. Here you go. We have a new label for the metrics. Before we move on, there's also one more trick that I want to share with you. Say for example, if you want to filter to specific country, every time when the user browses this dashboard, but you don't want to restrict this to a certain region. Say for example, US is my top country and I always want to filter to US, but I also want to have some flexibility where as my salespeople can see the sales from Canada and UK and so on. So what I can do is I can go to this control field and I can type in United States. So now we already set a default value to this delivery country filter. And when I click on it, I can still filter to other country or select more than one country if I want. So that's how we can utilize. I find it very useful in the business reporting. So this is just some tips, but for now, for my dashboard, I want to remove it. And because I don't need a default selection. And for the metric, I will also want to remove it because I don't think I would need that. So this is how it looks like after I remove the metric. Next, we will learn one of the most commonly used control in Data Studio, which is date range control. So to add a date range control, we can go to this, the same button, and at the lower part, select the date range control and click to add. So now we already have a date range control filter. This control gives the viewer a way to change the time frame of a report, so it allows your users to focus on a specific time frame that is important to them. Say for example, marketing folks may want to look at the report for the dates that they organize a campaign and 7 days before the campaign date starts. So having that functionality makes your dashboard more interactive and versatile to adapt to different use cases across the organization. Next, in the property panel, we can set the default date range. For now, it's set to auto date range by default, which includes the entire date range in your data set. You can also customize the date range by clicking on the dropdown. And from the calendar, you can use the top right dropdown to select the date range that you want to set as default. So here are some of the options that we have. We can fix it to a specific date range, or we can set it to a rolling last 7 days, last 14 days, 28 days, 30 days, and there are many, many more options here that can cater for your use case. Say for example, I can choose to have this month to date, and after I select it, you can see there's one tick over here that allows you to tick whether you want to include today's data or you want to exclude. So that's one option that you can set. After you have done with that, you can just click apply and it will be applied to the charts in the report. And that's all for creating the date range control. But before we call it a day, I want to mention a very important concept for the report date range, which I don't find many tutorials that talks about this on YouTube. So this is very crucial to understand if you have more than one date range in your data set. So if you notice, for every chart we create earlier, or even the filter control that we created, there is one date range dimension attached with every element. So this date range dimension will be always under the data tab and under the section of date range dimension within the data source. So this date range dimension actually governs the time frame of the selected charts. So let me give you an example here. So let's imagine we are a Data Studio machine, okay? The users tell us we need to create a chart with sales date and the metric sales revenue. So this chart can be filtered by this date range filter over here. But in Data Studio, this date range filter doesn't attach to any field. So if there's no field attached to this filter, how do we know that which field we're going to use to filter the data for this chart when the user select this? So how Data Studio going to work is they're going to find out what date range you have set for this chart. For example, for this time series chart, you have set the date range dimension to sales date. So when the user select month to date data, Data Studio will understand that that refers to the sales we have from 1st February to 25th February. So if this date range dimension change to date paid, the meaning changes. That means we want Data Studio to pull us the sales revenue that's been transacted or paid within 1st February and 25th February. And in some scenario, the sales date and the date that people make the payment can be different. So the sales revenue you're getting will be different as well. So that's one very important concept that you have to understand. In summary, you can put different date range fields in different charts. Data Studio supports this function really well without much work needed from the developer. So it's a good thing. On the other side, you will also need to take note because maintaining this date range dimension in so many charts, it's a bit troublesome, I would say. So if you like today's tutorial or you have learned something new, don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.